Let's get to a more complex design in our little series about image tracing. So as you can see, there are gradients in here. All the colored shapes have gradients in them. And let's see what image trace does with gradients. If we check the auto color and then see the result, then you see all the gradients are gone. And this actually is a good thing because we can try and get them back. I'm going to move this to more colors and then we will get more colors. And you see what Illustrator makes of the gradients. It makes single shapes, single colored shapes of them. So Illustrator cannot auto trace gradients. It will always split them up into solid colored shapes. And these will be a pain to reunite, and you will see that along the edges. So you see those will look bad along the edges if you later unite them. So the better way is to actually have it traced with fewer colors and then after expanding, apply the gradients to it and then you get the better result. Now in this case, we have another thing. So this consists of just straight lines. So snap curves to lines is absolutely crucial for this. And also the corners are all pointy. So let's move that way to the right. And you see we get better results with that and can improve that with these settings. There are still some issues in it. So you see there are curves in here and those are quite difficult to sort out. Maybe we can reduce the fidelity and might get better results. But with this thing, we already touch the limits of image tracing because it's not really good with geometric precision. Let's take a look at how to get the gradients back. Now, first of all, we need to adjust something in that trace. So this has the white background, as has all the other images that we have already traced. And we need to get rid of that. Now, if I set this up to ignore the white color, then we do not see what's happening. Let's go to the transparency grid and you see we can see through the eye and the mouth as well because they are white. And when you ignore white, then Illustrator ignores all the white. Now, what you can do is, of course, get that back when later editing. And I'm going to hide the transparency grid again and make a duplicate of this. And then let's go in here and set one of them up differently. So I'm going to set them up to overlapping, which creates different kind of shapes. And then let's take these two and see the difference between them. And I'm going to expand both of them. And now in this case, you see the white has been ignored. And in the transparency grid, we have see-through eye and see-through mouth. And in this case here, we have all the shapes, but this is very special. So let's go and ungroup this. And then you see we can move this independently. It's just a rectangle in the back. So Illustrator has stacked them. Now, what did it do with these triangles on the body? Is this a black body with triangles on top? And how is the difference? So in order to check that out, let's go into outline view. And you see here, they do not overlap because overlapping is only for those that are completely surrounded. And these do not completely surround. So they just overlap slightly. The difference to this one is they do not overlap at all. They are neighbored, which makes editing afterwards quite difficult. So in this case, you can slightly edit them, and also you do not get the gaps between them, those tiny white lines that sometimes happen in PDFs, because in this case they overlap. So this might be the better option in some cases. So in order to get back the gradients, let's move the template here. Of course, you select the shapes, go to the gradient panel, and then you set up that gradient. And what you can do is drag this into the gradient and then drag one of them out. And then we can double click this one, take the eyedropper and click here. And then, of course, you need to take the gradient tool. And let's go here, set this up. And again, we need to rotate that. So let's go here, rotate it, and of course, adjust it. I'm going to need to move that to the side. And then you see this needs to be set up like whatever you need to do. So maybe pick this up from here, make it darker. And that needs to be done. So this is how you trace gradients.